was worse than the grave. I threw coke in the pot, washed it, blew vessel doing consumed. It started waving, had a light and dope spoon. And try to kill you for your recipe. My shooting nasal drip flowing heavenly. Ducking my third felony. Take your shine. 2 for 5, me and mine's running from suit and ties. You say you the flyest, then who am I? Balenciaga with the hell. Lemonade, a popular drink still. With long jean jacket, rockin' so be real. Overpass, I'm too exquisite. On the dance floor, trying to finger f- on every visit. Some to never risk it. Hopping in BMs and proud of moccasin shit. They never had a pot to body Porsche on Cavalli dishes. On my hollin' in the dry Porsche while my loafers crocodile styling. I be having greater visions. You can tell by the way I whip it. You getting money, then the haters with it. It ain't dry, told them, wait a minute. Praise Pope for the way I did it.
I swear Paris will be prayed for. Pray for. Unrelease off white to the ankles. Hey, hey. I'm in them places that you can't go. Don C, Nego, in the same bro. The same way. I swear Paris will be prayed for. I need Casablanca by the caseline. Silks with the oranges in the mangoes. I'm a model now, baby, got the face for
yeah,
the face.
Yeah.
I swear Paris will be prayed for.
I'm from an era of hard knocks and quiet stones. Rap songs about crack rocks and firearms in the stash spot on some money mission. Adjust the AC, conceal the biscuit. It's your life, you can choose to risk it if you wanna. Don't want smoke, they want some marijuana. I used to get kicked out of class just for my aroma. I went to school high, forgot to pick up my diploma. It's way back when we used to cipher Arizonas. Now I'm in that Maybach, I'm with Puff and Hova. We been in corners in the 6 deuce. Talk about last night's $10,000 bottles of Patron. Sip it like it's juice, homie. How could I lose? That these fools are due to be in my shoes. I'm done playing by rules. Learn from OGs, I'm retiring the jewels. Everything's plain Jane, different days, same thing. I mean it's usual. Everything that's new to you be the type of I'm used to. I can give a about the hate I'm used to. If it's me, then know the feeling is mutual.
I swear here, pray for pray. Unrelease all flight to the ankles, ankles. I'm in the places that you can't go. Don C, Nego, in the same bro, the same way. I swear Paris will be prayed for. I need Casablanca by the caseload. Silks with the oranges and the mangoes. I'm a model now, baby, got the face for it. Face for it. I swear Paris will be prayed for.
Feeling good.
Everybody say yeah.
When I walk in, ring the bells. Roses at my feet, kneel, yell. Glitter on my neck, match the glitter on my fingernails. Always got something to say, well, them same guys was mighty till they got the ducking. We got the pucks and we chucking, they playing chicken, we clucking. I'm Colonel Sanders to you mother, trash and we dumping. I've been rapping and he 6'5", I'm a munchkin. And we speed to the disco. This car came with a driver, I'm in the back playing frontin'. I ain't crying, the wind is flying. Stop making assumptions, I ain't lying or nothing. Yes, I'm so happy. I turn nothing to something, skin glowing, my head nappy. My health good, my mama good, my too. When they only wanna have good times like Josh Safdie. We eat good, long way from Macca's Burgers. Long way from that Metro bus taxes service. Long way local gangs try to taxidermy. Run until our mother backs was burning. But anyway, the short and the socks hot. And the emerald shining, them GQs and them pop pies. And I spy with my private eye that you tried. You cannot pull this look off.
I swear Paris will be prayed for. Pray for. Unrelease all flight to the ankles. Hey, hey. I'm in the places that you can't go. Don C, Nego, in the same bro. The same way. I swear Paris will be prayed for. I need Casablanca by the caseload. Silks with the oranges and the mangoes. I'm a model now, baby, got the face for it. Face for it. I swear Paris will be prayed for. Pray for.
Yeah.
welcome to Eclectic Radio.
Listening to Eclectic Radio, here is the news. I'm Luke Morley. A landslide on the motorway in southern Brazil has killed at least two people and left dozens missing. A torrent of mud fell on the BR-376 highway in the state of Pernambuco, hitting more than 21 vehicles. Authorities said rescuers are currently at the scene and it is hoped that more survivors can be rescued before more rain falls later.
The number of people in hospital with the flu has jumped by 40% in the past week, according to official figures. An average of 482 patients a day were in hospital with the flu last week, compared to 444 the week before. Adult norovirus cases also jumped by more than a quarter, with 157 beds taken up each day last week, up from 126. Norovirus is often called the winter vomiting bug because it makes patients very sick for a short period.
In football news, Declan Rice has indicated that he wants to leave West Ham by speaking of his ambition to win trophies and play in the Champions League. The England midfielder has no intention of extending his deal and he is expected to be sold for a big fee next summer.
Britain's car theft capital has been named as Romford in East London, taking the mantle from neighbouring Ilford, which has earned the unwanted crown last year. The locations with the worst record for stolen motors were identified by analysing the numbers of motorists per area who reported a vehicle pinched in the last 5 years. Thank you for listening to Eclectic Radio. You're now up to date with the newest news. You are listening to Eclectic Radio. Playing the best music live to you, both old and new. Hello, welcome back to Eclectic Radio. I'm Tom Shadbolt and today I'm with
Harvey Webster
and Luke Morley.
And today we're talking about how TikTok possibly could have ruined music for most people and possibly the future. I'd like to start off saying how TikTok, I mean, loads of people put music into TikTok, any song's on TikTok, and people reverse it, speed it up, and you never really hear the original. Like, people make videos of possibly a TV show, add like a short clip of a TV show, and have like a sped up version of a random song over it. People never hear the original. What do you guys think about that?
Well, personally, I think it ruins what the original song is trying to accomplish. Like, if you just speed it up and or play it in reverse, you're not getting the message of the song.
Exactly. Sometimes maybe people use the instrumental as well. You never actually hear the lyrics and what the effort people have put into that song. Even if it's a small artist who's just made a song, might have a really good beat and then some decent lyrics, people might just add an instrumental and then you never hear the actual, like, original, you know?
Yeah. Also, I've been a fan of songs in the past and then, like, heard it just blow up on like TikTok and social media, and it kind of ruins the song because you just hear it all the time.
Exactly.
All these remixed versions and everything.
Bad Habit by Steve Lacy is a massive example. Yeah, yeah. Obviously, because that's just blown up on TikTok. And without TikTok, do you reckon Steve Lacy would still be as popular as he is?
I really don't think so. Like, have you seen the clips from his shows where like people only know like verse of the song?
That's the thing.
That's why. That's like the consequence of it.
Yeah, because on TikTok, people, like, videos can only be a minute long, can't they?
Yeah.
So,
like,
or no, I think they can be up to 10 minutes long, but no one's going to add like a 10 minute long video clip or anything.
Yeah.
So they'll just add a short part of Bad Habit by Steve Lacy, and people only know that part.
Yeah.
Because when he plays the other part, people just repeat the same. What is it? Didn't they repeat themselves? And he was like, restart the song.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what he said. Yeah.
He stormed off stage and got angry and everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, I think, have you guys heard any songs, like, on TikTok that you've then become a fan of?
I think one we just played, Hana Dollar. Mm. I literally would have
Did you hear that on TikTok?
Yeah, heard that on TikTok. Alpha House, which is coming up soon. I've heard that off TikTok as well. What about you, Luke? What songs?
I'm trying to think, because there's so many songs that I've listened to on TikTok, then I would have eventually hear the actual real song, but there's so many great songs that are on TikTok that I've went back and listened to.
No, I know. I mean, it's a big topic right now. Anyway, this is Alpha House by Nux.
Legends call them knuckles. 10 years old in beef, dad thinks streets taking over me. Mumsy praying for me, but there ain't enough beads on the rosary. Raised by the rules from young, but still in the jungle like Mowgli. Always up front when the oldest speaks, so whenever it's done,
it's on to me.
Choosing a spliff by the lift, it be what it be, and it is what it is. That's it, if I tried it, they wild and a kick in my cause it isn't for kids. Four floors on my ting where they live. If a fam never moved out to Harrow, a dad was a pastor, a marge was paro. I take a daughter off the calm and narrow. You with a peppercorn, yeah, I know it seems kinda deep, but their thoughts were shallow. Spent my whole life on the market as a target that they point their arrows. Control it, then I pass it to Paolo. Kick a box on Albert Road. Coach said come down to Charles, cause I could've got scouted, but I was at home. Or I was outside with the homies, if only I could've advised me now. But even if I was down and out, I still come back to Alpha House.
No days off.
Yeah, I just made a banger, I'm like, where the skills? Been away at 5, make it sell. Told me take a day off, I said, LOL. All this music can't go sell itself, true. Mommy told me I should get a girl. Though I did with a vet that I can never tell. And a man is wet, that's what she said herself. It's kind of funny, cause she said she wet as well. I can never bring her to my band though. Handle all my business in my band though. Made this one last year, but it bangs though. Have it cutting through your ear like it's Van Gogh. Yo, business ain't cheap, I need 2 phones. Man, them ringing me for beats like I move Joe. Same day I got a loot, I caught my new stove. Whipping up my rhythms, leave the booth smoke. Yeah. I just made a yeah. Man, I'm always warming with a rah rah. You can ask Maury, I'm their father. I just made a yeah, yeah. Man, I'm always booming with a rah rah. You can ask Maury, I'm their father. Man, and risk their life for a shiny belt. They sleep in YSL, but they lie as well. I could never tell a lie to my clientele. That's why they trust me with their time when we buy and sell. It's been ages since we came up as the new guys. Used to sling out the production just for 2-5. Can't give the assumption that I'm too nice. Must be bugging, I ain't budging on a new price. Who am I? I did it cause I had to. When the business turned to problems, what the man do? Huh? No, he's running like he had flu. Know the cash of cold when they point it at you. But I can never bring him to my band though. Handle all my business in my band though. I'ma need some rubbers for this bankroll. Mommy questioning the money that I bring home, yeah. I just made a yeah. Man, them only bought me with a rah rah. You can ask Maury, I'm their father. I just made a yeah. Man, them only bought me with a rah rah. You can ask Maury, I'm their. I just made a yeah.
Welcome to Eclectic Radio.
Welcome back to Eclectic Radio. I'm Luke Morley, and right now we're going to discuss about our content/live shows still relevant.
I think over the years they've become very, I don't know, they've gone down a bit. I feel like obviously you listen to about the Rolling Stones and the Beatles, they did concerts everywhere and they played everywhere. And now I feel like bands aren't really doing live concerts and gigs, and I feel like doing gigs in like little places, maybe like the Rolling Stones. I did happen to see them at Hyde Park a few months back, and that was really good. I feel like most concerts and live shows are mostly rap artists right now and hip hop, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I think because you can listen to music whenever you want, wherever you want.
Yeah.
There's not much need to go to a live show just to listen to the music. Mm. So people would just go for the experience.
Yeah.
And but also it's expensive, so I don't think as many people would be going to live shows, because you can just listen to it on your phone if you don't really care that much about having the experience. Mm. Luke, have you ever been to any live shows?
No, not myself. But another reason why I believe live shows and concerts are going downhill is because of COVID. Really, I think that's the final straw for those shows.
COVID, yeah, a lot of people might be scared a bit, to be honest, or any illness or whatever. But another thing I was going to say. There's a lot of effort that goes into making them, and a lot of money. Obviously, you've got the staff, the equipment, the venue, and obviously you have to prepare yourself. Obviously, the weekend has a massive tour coming up. I don't know if you've seen it.
I haven't.
After Hours Till Dawn, or something like that. But he's playing in London. He's playing all over the world. But every gig, every concert is within the matter of 2 days. So he's in one place, 2 days later he's in another place. And I feel like there's a lot of effort, and I feel like a lot of artists won't want to do that because of what people's expectations have been risen so much because of people like The Weeknd or making these massive concerts. They might not think it's good enough to go to just a little one, maybe around the corner in a little venue, and people might not want to do that, you know?
Yeah, and I think you really have to really like the artist to go to a concert because I like some of The Weeknd's music, but I don't think I'd go out of my way to pay to go and see him just because I'm not a big fan of him.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like you need to be a bigger fan of him to be able to
And know a decent amount of songs.
Yeah.
Obviously,
yeah.
Not just know the ones that are blown up, but also know the ones that haven't done as well.
Yeah. I know I saw one artist. I'm not entirely sure who it was. I know he had one song that really blew up on TikTok, and he was at a big concert, and it's one where people camp overnight and then go and see whatever artists they want. And he only had 13 people show up to his show.
Really?
Out of, all the, tens of thousands of people that were there.
I suppose. And, that's the problem. Also, that links into what we were talking about earlier about TikTok. Yeah. One song blew up and then no one wanted to hear the others.
Yeah.
I mean, that's same with Steve Lacy. I mean, he's got Static, Bad Habit, Dark Red, Yeah,
they're all good songs, and another good song is Fear by Kendrick Lamar.
What's up, family? Yeah, this your cousin Carl, man. Just giving you a call, man. I know you've been having a lot on your mind lately, and I know you feel people ain't been praying for you. But you have to understand this, man, that we are a cursed people. Deuteronomy 28:28 says, the Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart. See, family, that's why you feel like you got a chip on your shoulder.
Why God to suffer? Pain in my heart, carry burdens full of struggle. Why God do I gotta bleed? Every stone thrown at you, resting at my feet. Why God do I gotta suffer? Earth is no more, won't you burn this mother?
I beat your talking back, I beat your bought you that, you stole it. I beat your ass if you say that game is broken. I beat your ass if you jump on my couch. I beat your ass if you walk in this house with tears in your eyes, running from poor, poor apprentice. Go back outside, I beat your ass, little. That homework better be finished. I beat your teachers better not be about you in class. That piece of bed not be wasted. You eat it all. The TV better not be loud if you got it on. Them Jordans better not get dirty when I just bought them. Better not hear about you on Keisha's daughter. Better not hear you got caught up. I beat your, you better not run to your father. I beat your, you know my patience running thin. I got boo-boo payments to make. County buildings on my, trying to take my food stamps away. I beat your if you tell them social workers he live here. I beat your if I beat your twice and you still here. 7 years old, think you run this house by yourself? You gon' fear me if you don't fear no one else.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that mother up.
And then I take two puffs. Now.
Life's a pull 'em to the side now.
I probably die anonymous, I probably die with promises. I probably die walking back home from the candy house. I probably die because these colors are standing out. I probably die because I ain't know DeMarcus was snitching. I probably die at these house parties. I probably die from witnesses leaving me false accused. I probably die from thinking that me and your hood was cool. Or maybe die from pressing the line, acting too extra. Or maybe die because these smokers are more than desperate. I probably die from one of these pats and blue badges. Body slammed in black and white paint, my bones snapping. Or maybe die from panic, or die from being too lax. Or die for waiting on it, die cause I'm moving too fast. I probably die trying to bout at the apartments. I probably die trying to defuse two homies arguing. I probably die cause that's what you do when you're 17. My worries in a hurry, I wish I controlled things.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that mother up.
Fear accumulated 10 times over throughout the years. My newfound life made all of me magnified. How many accolades do I need to block denial? The shock value of my success put bolts in me. All this money, is God playing a joke on me? Is it for the moment and will he see me as Job? Take it from me and leave me worse than I was before. At 27, my biggest fear was losing it all. Scared to spend money, had me sleeping from hard to hard. Scared to go back to Section 8 with my mama stressing. 30 shows a month and I still won't buy me no Lexus. What is an advisor? Somebody that's holding my checks. Just to f*** me over and put my finances in debt. I read a case about Rihanna's accountant and wonder. I did the bad girl feel when she looked at them numbers. That type of f*** that make me flip out and just some, drill some. Get ill and feel wretched with a little some. My practice running from fear. Guess I had some good luck. At 27 years old, my biggest fear was being judged. How they look at me, reflect on myself, my family, my city. What they say about me reveal if my reputation will miss me. What they see from me will trickle down generations in time. What they hear from me will make them highlight my simplest lines. I'm talking fear. Fear losing creativity. I'm talking fear. Fear missing out on you and me, I'm talking fear. Fear losing loyalty for pride, cause my DNA won't let me involve in the light of God. I'm talking fear. Fear that my humbleness is gone, I'm talking fear. Fear that love ain't living here no more, I'm talking fear. Fear that is wickedness or weakness. Fear, whatever it is, both is distinctive. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth. And I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse. Within 14 tracks, carried out over wax. Searching for resolutions until somebody get back. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth. And I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse. Within 14 tracks, carried out over wax. Wondering if I'm living through fear or living through rap.
Damn.
Damn you. Damn me. Damn us. Damn we. Damn us all.
have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities. So until we come back to these commandments, until you come back to these commandments, we're going to feel this way. We're going to be under this curse, because he said he's going to punish us, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, are the true children of Israel. We are the Israelites according to the Bible. The children of Israel, he's going to punish us for our iniquity, for our disobedience, because we chose to follow other gods that are the mansions of his son.
Come in from the cold this winter in Jackson's Cafe and enjoy a homemade cake ranging from 8 to 15 pounds, an all-day breakfast and brunch.
We are a dog-friendly family-run business that welcome all. Jackson's Cafe is part of a larger charity, Unity Works, that works to create a better community and future for all that are in need due to learning disabilities.
Jackson Cafe is a truly magical place, giving people the chance to live their best lives by providing much needed skills for an independent life. But don't take our word for it, pop down to 47 High Street, Romford to see for yourself.
You are listening to Eclectic Radio. Playing the best music live to you, both old and new.
Hello and welcome back to Eclectic Radio. I just want to bring up a topic. I just want to talk about our Spotify rap this year.
Mine is really different. Mine's really not what I expected, but Spotify rap is basically... So, I think Spotify is probably the most popular music platform that is used around the world. I might be wrong, but I would have thought so. But
yeah.
Spotify Wrapped basically adds up all the minutes you've listened to music this year, and it tells you your top genre, the top songs, and the top artists you've listened to. So, Harvey, kick it off. What's your minutes?
Should we talk about genres first?
Oh, yeah? Go on then.
So, obviously, it tells you your top five, but my first one was rap.
Yeah. What top genre?
Yeah.
Mine's rap too.
What about you, Luke? What was your top genre?
Same, it's also rap.
My second was underground hip-hop.
Was it?
I'm pretty proud of that.
Right.
What about you guys?
Mine was, for second, it's classical.
Classical?
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Really? Did you use classical to study, or...?
No, I just...
At the gym? Classical music at the gym?
No, listen to it whenever I feel like it.
Mine was indie rock.
It was the second one?
Yeah.
Yeah. I have no idea what this is, but my third one is called Vapor Trap. I have no idea what that's called. Right.
But I think that's similar to, like, sort of electric, maybe. Mm. But anyway, minutes listened. How many minutes listened have you got?
Alright, I don't think this is very much.
Right.
Because I listen to Apple Music and Spotify and SoundCloud.
Right.
So for Spotify, it's 6,234.
Right.
That's not much.
I feel like it's quite a lot.
Is it?
But mine's quite a lot.
What's your one?
20,414.
Fair enough. That is quite a lot.
What about you, Luke?
Mine's 8,614.
Oh, right.
Oh, wow. That's more than me as well.
Yeah. I mean, if you use Apple Music as well.
Yeah.
I listen to music all the time, on the bus, walking home, at the gym, all the time. Who's your top artist?
I think next it says top song. So I'm on top song right now.
Right, okay. I've just downloaded mine.
Oh, you downloaded it?
It adds it up into like a whole page at the end.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So who's
your
top artist?
My top artist is Tyler, the Creator.
That's a surprise. I'm joking, it's not. That's what you listen to. What's your favourite song from Tyler, the Creator, then?
I don't know. Not sure.
Mine's Best Interests.
Oh, nice.
Well, my top artist is The Jam. It's a band.
Okay, I've never heard of them, I don't think.
No, it's like a really old band. I'm really surprised, because I listened to them I did listen to them quite a lot. But it's an old band, but my second artist is Tame Impala. Do you know Tame Impala?
Okay, yeah.
And then my third, Uzi Vert, fourth, Kendrick, and then fifth, Carti.
Mine was Tyler, the Creator, Juice WRLD, Frank Ocean, Kendrick Lamar, Baby Keem.
Okay.
What about you, Luke?
My top artist is Drake.
Yeah,
that's a surprise as well.
It's not. Yeah, I love Drake, as you can probably tell.
Yeah.
And my second one is Baby Keem. Surprise.
Okay, yeah.
And my third one is Juice WRLD.
Oh, okay.
All right. Cool.
You a Juice WRLD fan?
Yeah, I listen to.
His third top artist. I would have thought so.
All right. So, what's your favorite Juice WRLD song? Like, let me guess. Lucid Dreams.
Yes, it actually is.
Yeah.
Okay.
What about top songs then?
My top song was Ivy by Frank Ocean.
Right. Mine's somehow Jalil Juice.
Jalil Juice? Yeah, how is that your top?
I don't know. At the start of the year, I think that's when it came out anyway, I played it the hell out of it. But Luke. I haven't played it since, yeah. And that is a complete truth.
Can we guess what Luke's is? I'm going to guess it's God's plan.
Yes, yes, it is God's plan.
Okay, fair enough.
What do you reckon Luke's plan is? Luke, do you reckon you should make up a plan to listen to some different music next year?
Yes, okay. Yeah. I want to do that.
Drake's getting a bit dried off, I'm not going to lie.
Luke. He is. Since Certified Lover Boy, I don't think. What do you think of Honestly Nevermind? It was all right. I feel like it's the sort of music you'd hear in like Marks and Spencer's and H&M.
Oh, Honestly Nevermind?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I think their new one, that's
Her Loss
is good. I actually do like it a lot. I've just seen my Apple Music one was 3,000 minutes.
Right. I haven't.
So all in all, it's actually not that much.
6, 7, 8, 9, 9,000 minutes total.
That's not that much.
It's not. I thought you was a really like avid music listener.
I listen to music all the time.
Well, you might be lying, mate.
I'm not. I'm being serious. I actually do. But obviously not that much on Spotify and Apple Music.
No, that's fair enough. What else do you use? Do you use YouTube Music?
I don't have YouTube Music, but I mean, I do listen to music on YouTube. If I'm on YouTube, I should listen to music on YouTube.
Luke, you're quite an avid YouTube Music user, aren't you?
Yeah.
Do you watch the music videos while you're listening, or?
Yes. I put it on whenever I'm on the bus.
Right. Okay.
Anyway, this is Pink and White by Frank Ocean.
The way every day goes, every time we've no control. If the sky is pink and white, if the ground is black and yellow, it's the same way you showed me. Nod my head, don't close my eyes, halfway on a slow move. It's the same way you showed me. If you could fly, then you'd feel south. Up north's getting cold soon. The way it is, we're on land. So I'm someone I hold true. Keep you cool when it's still alive. Won't let you down when it's all ruined. Just the same way you showed me. Showed me. You showed me love. Of a summer shade, nose dive in the flood lines, tall tower, milk crate. It's the same way you showed me. Cannonball off the porch side, older kids trying off the roof. Just the same way you showed me. You showed. If you could die and come back to life, up for air from the swimming pool, you kneel down to the dry land, kiss the earth that birthed you. Gave you tools just to stay alive and make it up when the sun is ruined. That's the same way you showed me. Showed. You showed me love.
Welcome to Eclectic Radio.
Welcome back to Eclectic Radio, and now we're talking about whether AI is set to take over the creative industry or not. What do you guys think?
I've personally seen a lot of things like recently about AI and like advances in like technology and stuff.
Yeah.
In like the creative industry.
Yeah. One thing that stands out to me is when people type in a word or an idea, and then the AI recreates it. And like I saw this one on TikTok. It was like a man sat looking at a nuclear explosion or something like that. Then the AI created it.
Yeah.
To like its own. I don't know how it works, but
yeah,
it looked exactly. It just made a picture basically.
Yeah, I've seen. I saw a video on YouTube, and it was these people. They're like VFX artists.
Right.
They went on one of those websites and basically typed in. It was Tom Holland Spider-Man, but in the style of like Into the Spider-Verse.
Right.
And they could record themselves like in real life, like moving about.
Wow.
And it would just paste it onto their body and make it them. And they made like an Into the Spider-Verse like trailer, but just using the AI software.
Wow!
And it looks quite similar to the Into the Spider-Verse. Mm. So my question to you guys is: do you think that would, like, take the place of actual animators and stuff, or do you think that people would still?
There'll always be a job for animators, such as in anime. Anime is always going to be there, and it's always going to be an industry that has loads of money within it, and the animators, they're just not going to lose their jobs. I feel like animators in anime are very different to the ones that are in, such as an example, Call of Duty. It's really different. They wear the blue suits, or they possibly go out dressed as the characters within the game, and they actually recreate like the cutscenes and all that. But I feel like they're two different industries. So partially, no, I don't think so, no.
Because I feel like when you watch like something that's animated, you kind of see like the effort that people have gone into and everything. Like, let's say, like, I don't know, The Simpsons. Right. If The Simpsons wasn't hand-drawn every frame, would you still like be like, oh, wow, this is impressive? Like, if it was just made by a computer, they typed in what they wanted the characters to do and it just happened.
No. It'd seem effortless, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
There'd be no money within the industry because people would know how it's made. If they stuck to how the looks and possibly the humour and everything involved in shows such as The Simpsons and Family Guy, I feel like people wouldn't really care. Because they don't watch it for the effort the artist has put in.
I think the thing about like the creative industry as a whole, the reason that there's so much money in it and there's jobs in it is because everyone in there, they have a particular skill set that not everybody has.
Yeah.
So if AI can just do everything that these people can do, then
so many jobs are going to be lost.
So many jobs would be lost, and you wouldn't need to have skill to be able to do it.
Yeah. Anyway, Luke, do you find it scary that AI is having these sort of skill sets to do what a human can do? Do you find it scary, or are you scared of the possible future?
Well, personally, I believe that AI, no matter what it can do, no matter how many skills it can learn, I feel like there's a place for like animators, because even though AI is really advanced compared to like us, there's always going to be a place for us because we've all got different skills.
No, I know. The thing is, AI can't complete a task unless it's been taught by a human. So we would be at fault if we were to cause all these job losses. I mean, an AI can't just do that without it being taught to do that, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So we'd be the only problem causing the jobs to be lost, obviously.
Yeah, but as well, like, AI is advancing so much. I think about, like, 10 years ago, stuff that's happening now, you might not have even imagined that it was happening.
No,
and think about, like, 50 years ago, like, no one would have even thought of it.
Right.
And so do you think that in the next, like, 10, 20, 30 years, how far do you think AI would advance? And isn't there a certain point where we have to stop and just, like, think that's enough? Because if it gets to the point where the AI can write its own code and everything, what's going to happen then? Because we won't be able to control it.
Obviously, there's these films where AI take over, such as iRobot.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've watched that one. But I feel like AI is scary and what it can compete against, for example, us. I believe Elon Musk has spoke about it. He said AI will take over, and knowing how much money he's got and knowing what he does, I feel like we can trust him and believe him on that.
Yeah.
But I feel like, knowing humanity, I don't feel like we will stop.
So we'll did Stephen Hawking as well. Right. Stephen Hawking actually said that the end of the world would be because of AI. Mm. It is a bit scary to think about, but at the same time, there's a lot of good with AI as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a lot to talk on about it. But anyway, this is 90210 by Travis Scott.
Cause she said, Travi, you work too hard. I'm worried you forget about me. I'm falling in and out of clubs. Don't worry, I'ma get it, granny. What happened now? My daddy happy. Mama called me up, that money coming, and she let me. I done made it now. I done found like meaning now. All them days are hard to break. Her heart out in pieces now. Friends turning into fraud. Practicing half the passion, you need package different. All you need, you need. Well, that's why you can have it. I'ma sell it. You need salary, bout to cap it. Youngest nigga out of Houston at the Grammys. Smiling at him, laughing at me. I pass a rock to Yankee Punk, faked it, passed it back. All of this off a rabbit. Should've wrote this in Latin. Yeah. I know. Guzzle said we in the stove. Yeah, we bout to drop a four. He passed a cigarette, I choke. Told my auntie, put them poles down, them poles down. Now you know you love your own now. Hit the stage, they got their hands up. Don't put your nose down. I ain't knocking, I knock the dough down for sure now.
Whole crew, I swear they counting on me. Gold chains, gold rings, I got a island on me. Houses on me, he got the mouses on him. Holy father, come save me, niggas, I'm styling on him. Good lord, I see my good fortune in all these horses. I'm driving too fast to stop, so all these signs, I ignore them. Just the sky from north to the border, my chins is in order. My mom's biggest supporter, so now I'm supporting it.
You are listening to Eclectic Radio. Playing the best music live to you, both old and new.
Welcome back to Eclectic Radio, and now we're going to discuss how our childhood possibly affected us being on this course. Kick it off, Harvey.
I joined this course because I'm interested in animation. That's like why I joined it at first. But yeah. I really enjoy like other aspects of it so far. But yeah, I mean, when I was younger, when I used to like watch like kids' TV shows and stuff, right. A lot of them are animated, yeah. And I was always just like interested in like how they're making the drawings like move, you know, even like when I was really young.
Horrid Henry, how did they make that?
Yeah, I know. I always used to just think like, how, like, I knew it was drawing. I knew obviously they weren't real people, but how are they making it move and everything? And as soon as I found out like you could do that as a job, since then I've always wanted to do it.
Right. I feel like this course is perfect if you have a creative mindset and you want to express your mindset. Obviously, Horrid Henry is a massive example, obviously. How did they make that? Luke, do you have any ideas?
Hand-drawn it, and then they used software to make the characters move.
Well, they animated it.
Yeah.
So but they would just draw so every old. Frame.
Did they have...
It's not that old. It's really not that old.
When did it come out? 2003?
Yeah, something like that.
So what would they have used? Not After Effects.
What are you... They just animated it. How do you think they made, like, Tom and Jerry?
Right.
They just drew every frame individually.
Oh, okay. Right.
That's probably how they did it. What? Wait, Luke. Why are you on this course?
Oh, because I'm interested in like film, like filming the special effects, like in especially like live action movies. Like how do they, like with the green screen and everything. It's really impressive of what they can do, if they use the CGI well.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like coming on this course, it really allows us all to look into the industry. Obviously, going into the second year, just to let the listeners know, going into the second year, we can either choose to go into developing more skills into how the film industry works or into the animation industry. I mean, what will you guys want to choose?
I mean, I'm sure I'll pick like the After Effects and everything, that side
animation
of it, because that's why I joined the course.
Yeah.
And I really enjoy like the film side of it and everything.
Right.
But I just don't see... I'd rather develop my skills on like After Effects and everything, because I know that if I have the creative mind to do something, to do a film, and I have like the things to do, I can go and do that, you know. But I think it would be good to just get more skills in like After Effects and everything. But I'm not sure. We have time.
Yeah. What about you, Luke?
I personally would like to develop my skills in the film industry, because I want to either be a director or an actor when I grow up.
Fair enough. I mean,
could be both.
Yeah.
Good for you. Yeah. What about you, Tom?
Well, I'm fine with both. I love editing. I love editing videos, animation, but I also love filming. When one of our course topics was to go out and record a music video, and I think we all personally really enjoyed it, didn't we, guys?
Yeah.
But then we also enjoyed sitting in the booth and animating it and adding effects. We also enjoyed that side of things. So personally, I wouldn't really mind what side of things we choose. I choose within the course.
Yeah, 100%. I really enjoyed that. I enjoyed every aspect of that, to be fair.
I mean, I think booking out the camera was unique. I mean, I don't think you guys ever did anything like that in secondary school, because I definitely didn't.
No, I've never had like a proper camera filmed with it.
This is All Right by Kendrick Lamar.
All's my life I has to fight. All's my life I hard times like yeah, bad trips like yeah. Nazareth, I'm f***ed up, homie, you f***ed up. But if God got us, then we gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Huh? We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be alright.
And when I wake up, I recognize you looking at me for the pay cut. Bahamas, I be looking at you from the face down. One Mac 11, even boom with the face down. Skimming, and let me tell you about my life. Painkillers only put me in the twilight. We're pretty, Benjamin is the highlight. I tell my mama I love her, but this what I like, Lord knows. 20 of them in my Chevy, tell them all to come and get me. Reaping everything I sow, so my karma come in heaven. No preliminary hearings on my record. I'm a gangster in silence for the record. Tell the world I know it's too late. Boys and girls, I think I've gone crazy. Trying to side my face, it's all day. Won't you please believe when I say, when you know we've been hurt, been down before. When our pride was low, looking at the world like, where do we go? And we hate po-po, wanna kill us dead in the street for sure. I'm at the preacher's door, my knees getting weak and my gun might blow. But we gon' be alright, alright.
We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Huh? We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be alright.
What you want? You a house, you a car, 40 acres and a mule, a piano, a guitar, anything. See, my name is Lucy, I'm your dog. Motherfucker, you can live at the mall. I can see the evil, I can tell it, I know it's illegal. I don't think about it, I deposit every other zero. Thinking of my partner, put the candy, painting on a Rico. Digging in my pocket, in a profit, big enough to feed you. Every day my logic, get another dollar just to keep you in the presence of your Chico. I don't talk about it, be about it, every day a sequel. If I got it, then you know you got it, heaven I can reach you. Pet dog, pet dog, pet dog, my dog, that's all. Pick back and chat, I trap the back for y'all. I rap, I black on tracks, so rest assured. My rights, my wrongs, I write till I'm right with God. When you know, we've been hurt, been down before. When our pride was low, looking at the world like, where do we go? And we hate po-po, wanna kill us dead in the street for sure. I'm at the preacher's door, my knees getting weak and my gun might blow. But we gon' be alright, alright.
We gon' be alright, we gon' be alright. We gon' be alright, do you hear me, do you feel me? We gon' be alright, we gon' be alright.
I remember you was conflicted, misusing your influence. Sometimes I did the same, abusing my power full of resentment. Resentment that turned into a deep depression. Found myself screaming in the hotel room.
Modera is back better than ever with the new Royal Alloy scooters. Styled just like the original Italian Lambrettas of the 60s and 70s, but with new modern technology to withstand all weather and take on any journey for years to come.
Dunton Scooters began during COVID just outside of Brentwood.
It's now relocating to Crynham, Essex, just behind Balloon Fire Wonderland. We look forward to seeing you.
Welcome to Eclectic Radio.
to Eclectic Radio. Today we're going to,
again,
kick it off with another fun one. We're going to talk about what media we have recently watched. I'm just going to start off by just saying Peaky Blinders. I just can't stop watching it.
You've watched it?
I've watched it twice.
Well, you've rewatched it?
Twice. I just can't stop watching it. I love the style. I love the videography. I love the cinematography.
Yeah.
It's just so good. I love the acting. What about you, Luke? What you watched recently?
I've watched a bit of the Bear on Disney Plus.
Oh, did you? You started watching it?
Yes.
What did you think of it, Luke?
I think it's pretty funny, to be honest.
Well, you actually started watching it?
Yeah.
Well, after Harvey recommended it.
Yeah, because I have Disney Plus.
Mm. I don't have Disney Plus. I don't have it.
She's recently rewatched the movie Waves. Have you guys seen that?
No.
You've never seen Waves?
Never seen Waves.
It's a really good film. I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed it the first time, that's why I rewatched it again.
What's it about?
It's about this. First, it follows like the story of a boy. This boy and he's like, and like this boy and a girl, like, they're kind of in love, innit?
Right.
And stuff happens. I'm not gonna ruin it, but then it changes story to his sister. So it's kind of two different stories in one, but they're going on at the same time. Basically, it's a really good watch. You should watch it.
What's it on? Sky.
Netflix.
Oh, it's on Netflix. Right. Yeah. Okay.
Cool.
What else you watched, Luke? Any TV shows or anything?
Not recently, no. I've not really watched a lot of stuff.
Right.
What about you, Tom?
I've watched The Boys.
Again? You rewatched it again?
Maybe.
Oh, nice.
I should start watching that as well. Two favourite shows, Peaky Blinders and The Boys.
They are really really good ones.
I need to find something new.
Well, I mean, I just finished watching Snowfall. That's also on Disney Plus.
Right.
But the second season is on BBC iPlayer.
Right. Are you guys into shows such as Better Call Saul and Breaking Bad?
Yeah, I'm into Breaking Bad. I really like Breaking Bad. Yeah.
Same.
I've finished it. What about Better Call Saul?
I started watching it. I think I'm like midway through the first season. Same. But the first two seasons are apparently not very good.
No.
And I was getting quite bored of it.
Start.
Yeah.
Have you guys watched El Camino? Straight Carry On from Breaking Bad. You watched it?
Yeah.
You have, yeah? Where it's like Jesse, and it kicks straight off from the end of the show. Which I really like. I love it when TV shows do that.
I like it because I think the way that Breaking Bad ended, it kind of, it was a good ending, but I did want to know more, and I think that kind of, like, helped to kind of just, like, everyone that watched it settle their minds, you know?
Yeah.
I do think that what was a little bit weird, that obviously the characters were a lot older.
Right.
Some of them had, like,
Todd.
Changed a lot. Todd, he put on a lot of weight. So he was just very, very different.
Yeah. It's like he lost, like, a lot of weight in the matter of 2 months. Because it was flashbacks, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was flashbacks to when Jesse got kidnapped. But I really liked Heisenberg's death. I thought it was really good. It showed he died in his, let's say, happy place, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
But also the ending was pretty sad, wasn't it?
It was sad, yeah, but I think that it kind of needed to happen. Like, it needed to have an ending that was kind of just, like, the end. But yeah, I think that whole show is really good. Like, I've seen a lot of things of, like, there's, like, hidden details in it. And the cinematography in it is really good. That's something I really like about it as well.
I think the cinematography mostly happened during the mid-season. Because mid-season was when they were in the middle of the whole show. That's when Jesse and Heisenberg sort of went out to the desert. And sort of started cooking out there. But then it sort of went to urban. They were all sort of in the city, so... But the cinematography, when... What was unique about? I think the colour.
Oh, yeah, a lot of colours and everything. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, who directed it? Was Vince Gilligan.
Oh, was
directed it?
It.
And I know Bryan Cranston did some directing as well.
Did he?
Yeah, he did for some of the episodes.
Right.
But I think the directing is good because I didn't realise how much directing, like... helps to tell the story.
No.
Until I've, like, because I've seen stuff that's been edited badly, and, like, you can just tell it just takes you out of it, and you don't see the right things. But I think Vince Gilligan, I don't know if he's done anything else that I can think
not
of,
except for Better Call Saul. Yeah.
But, really good director.
He must have directed El Camino.
I would have thought so. It was different, obviously, because it's a movie.
Yeah.
So it definitely did feel different, but...
I love it how they got the actors back as well.
Yeah, that was
El Camino
really good.
Only came out 7 years ago.
Yeah.
Which meant Breaking Bad came out in 2008, am I right?
Yeah. Didn't El Camino come out in 2019?
Oh, was it 2019?
I'm pretty sure. I think it was 2019.
Sorry. Right, okay. 2019, yeah.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Better Call Saul was pre Breaking Bad, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And then. Actually, no, I was just about to spoil. Don't want to do that.
Oh,
I
no.
I haven't even watched the show, but I know spoilers.
Because I watched. You know the one that plays Jesse? Aaron Paul.
Yeah, Aaron Paul, yeah.
I actually watched him before Breaking Bad. I didn't even realise.
Yeah.
In the Need for Speed movie. What a movie.
He's in Central Intelligence as well.
Is he?
With Kevin Hart and Dwayne Johnson.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here's Devil in a New Dress.
I love it though, I love it though, you know? Put your hands to the constellations. The way you look should be a sin, you my sensation. I know I'm preaching to the congregation. We love Jesus, but you done learned a lot from Satan. Nina did a lot of waiting. We ain't married, but tonight I need some consummation. May the Lord forgive us, may the gods be with us. In that magic hour, I seen good Christians make rash decisions. Oh, she do it, what happened to religion? Oh, she lose it, she putting on her makeup. She casually a Lord, text message breakups, the casualty of torch. How she gon' wake up and not love me no more? I thought I was the... I guess it's rubbing off, hood phenomenon, the LeBron rhyme. Hard to be humble when you stunting on a jumbotron. I'm looking at her like, this what you really wanted, huh? Why we arguing anyway? Oh, I forgot it's summertime. Put your hands to the constellations. The way you look should be a sin, you my sensation. I know I'm preaching to the congregation. We love Jesus, but she done learned a lot from Satan. Satan, Satan, Satan. I mean, you mean you did a lot of waiting. We ain't married, but tonight it needs some consummation. When the sun goes down, it's the magic hour. The magic hour. And out of all the colors that'll fill up the skies, you got green on your mind, I can see it in your eyes. Why you standing there with your face screwed up? Don't leave while you're hot, that's how May screwed up. Throwing stuff around the whole place screwed up. Maybe I should call May so he could pray for us. I hit the Jamaican spot at the bar, take a seat. I ordered your jerk, she said you are what you eat. You see, I always loved a sense of humor. But tonight you should have seen how quiet the room was. The Lior Cone, a Dior Homme, that's Dior Homme, that Dior homie. The Crip Scarface, could it be more Tony? You love me for me, could you be more phony? Put your hands to the constellation. The way you look should be a sin, you my sensation. Haven't said a word, haven't said a word to me this evening. Cat got your
to
Eclectic.
Eclectic Radio.
back to Eclectic Radio. We just want to say thank you for tuning in, and make sure to tune in every Friday from 10:30 to 12:00, possibly 11 till 12:00. Thank you.
Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much for listening.
And just to top it off, this is Pick Up the Phone by Travis Scott.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. Travis Scott, Tucker, baby.
Yeah. I go for, I call your up, just to fucking show up. I just went got my door, pull it off and I'm gone. Then I go up before, then I roll up, that roll up. Then I'm calling your up. I need all this cash. I got-